Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if this is your first time here. I am Jillian, and today's video is gonna be absolutely amazing. We have my friend Eric Sebbag here, all the way from New York. He is a celebrity hairstylist, a third generation hairstylist, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
And the best hairdresser I've ever had in my entire life. So he has so much knowledge to share with us on the best ways to care for our hair and get the best, thickest, fastest growing, most amazing, shiniest hair. And we are also going to discuss the foods that are great for your hair as well, because this is so key. Nutrition plays such a huge role in how our hair looks and feels. And that's been the case for me. My hair has done a complete 180 since being raw vegan in a really good way. So I am going to put a picture on the screen too right now so you guys can see just how much it's changed. And let's get started. Let's say hello to Eric. Hey, Eric, how's it going?
Hey, Jillian, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, I feel great. Good to be here in Toronto.
Thank you so much for being with us.
My pleasure.
So Eric is a good friend of mine, and like I said, the best hairdresser. And before I forget, make sure you guys hit the subscribe button. I post great weekly content every single week. So Eric, I want to talk to you first before we get into the foods that are best for your hair. I want to ask you some questions. And like I said, first of all, you're a third generation hairstylist. Yeah, so you learned from...
So my grandfather was a hairdresser. My father himself was a hairdresser, and that's where I learned.
Yeah.
And my father's salon in Montreal, beautiful upscale salon, a lot of workers. So I really got exposure from a lot of different hairstylists. So it was pretty amazing experience. I started when I was 15, so that was pretty young.
Wow.
Yeah, so total 33 years in the business.
Yeah.
It's been great.
Wow.
I'm really excited, yeah.
That's great.
I still have passion for it.
So. Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
That's what I love.
Yeah. You have to have passion for it, because hairdressing is, it's not easy. It's not easy. You have to like keep going and learning and, you know, just never stop doing hair.
Yeah, exactly. No, your passion shows. And I just want to say, no offense to the hairdressers who do have hair out there, but from my experience, the best hairdressers are bald guys. And that is the thing. And
I don't know why.
You're just like the only...
It's like the best shoemakers wear sandals.
Yeah, exactly, right? It's a thing. So the only haircut of my life I've ever liked is by you. So I want to get into the questions, because I know you have so much knowledge to share with my viewers tonight.
I will do the best I can.
Okay, so I want to ask first, how fast does our hair actually grow? People say about a half inch or an inch a month, but I mean, I feel
That's correct.
Your diet and lifestyle must play a part in that as well.
Well, I'll be honest with you, it just grows. Everybody's different. Majority of people, their hair will grow about a half an inch a month. So there's a very small majority of individuals whose hair will grow an inch a month. Not more than that. Anything more, maybe you're taking supplements, but it's very rare.
Mm-hmm.
I think it just grows thicker. Maybe that's what the difference is. Not so much faster,
okay.
Just grows thicker.
Okay, and this is a question I'm really wondering. How often should we wash our hair? I know some people that I'm friends with in the raw vegan community especially, they don't wash their hair at all, and they swear by it. They swear they have the best hair ever. I have been...
That's a good question, by
the way.
So, sorry, I didn't mean to
interrupt,
but that's a great question, because a lot of people, you know, they don't know how often they should wash their hair. To be honest with you, again, I'm going to say everybody's different, but there is one thing we all have in common, is that if we really use the most purest water, whether it's coming from a waterfall or an Evian bottle, your hair will be so much different. It'll shine, you'll get that volume. It acts as a shampoo and a conditioner, but it would have to be the purest form of water. But since we don't have that, and most of us live in cities where there's pollution, and of course the shampoos that we use and the products and the heat, you know, from the sun, all these things affect the hair. So in this day and age, my suggestion is, and I tell this to all my clients, definitely wash your hair anywhere between 1 to 2 times a week. If your hair is super greasy, then 3 times would be fine. But don't exceed 3 times, and don't do every single day, because your hair will get used to that, and that's not good. You want your hair to get used to not washing your hair often, and you'll see the change. So maybe it'll be greasy in the beginning, but give it a chance. You know, maybe rinse it with water as opposed to doing another shampoo. Just rinse it with water and see what happens. You know, a lot of people like to use like baby powder or maybe dry shampoo, But, you know, just try the water thing and try to break it down to like 3 times to 2 to 1 times a week.
Makes sense.
Yeah. And also, also change your shampoos. You should never use the same shampoo all the time. Mm. Definitely change it. Maybe have like 2 or 3 different brands of shampoo, different types of shampoo. If you color your hair, obviously use a color shampoo for colored hair that treats it. But that's my suggestion.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's great. Yeah. Good information. Yeah. I feel like too, with washing our hair, it affects the bacteria, like the bacteria on us and our oils. So that makes complete
sense.
Absolutely.
And I hate to say it, but sometimes like Pantene does work for some people, you know, whereas a vegan shampoo will not work as well. It all depends on the person.
You were on a vegan channel, though, Eric.
I know. I hate to say this, but it's like the truth. You know, it's like we haven't even gotten there yet, but we're on our way. I think people just need to know what works for them.
Yeah.
You know, like how did they do it in the olden days? How did they wash their hair?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is they. You know, I'm going to go back to the water thing. It's the water that stripped the oils that made your hair shiny and beautiful. And they were constantly always like in that water washing their hair or their body. So there's many ways to wash your hair. But if you could find a good vegan shampoo, then go for it.
I just ordered a new one. I'm so excited. I saw it on Dan McDonald's channel. It's my friend recommended it. It's a Moroccan one and it is supposed to be like the best vegan shampoo ever.
Oh, the Moroccan method.
Yeah, I forget what it's called. I don't know if it's the Moroccan method. I forget, but it was on back order. Apparently it's amazing. So I'll share it with you guys once I've tried it, if it is really good.
You know, that's the thing. Like do your research, like go jump in, try something new. Don't be afraid to try different shampoos because you may just find something you like that works for you. You know, maybe this Moroccan thing doesn't work, but this amazing shampoo from Peru works, you know? Mm-hmm. So it all depends on you.
Yeah.
Every person is different.
Okay. And I want to ask you next, does stress really affect hair? I have a family member. I know she went through some stressful times and she said it's like made her lose so much hair. Yeah. So
absolutely.
Yeah.
Stress, you definitely lose hair with stress. But people don't know if it's coming from stress or maybe it's something else.
Mm-hmm.
It could be a variety of things when you lose your hair. Majority of people will lose their hair because new hair is always growing and it pushes the old hair out. So when you have like little frizzies and you're like, oh my God, what is that? That's just new hair growing. Mm-hmm. So that's a natural process.
Oh, that's what that is.
Yeah, that's what that is. It's just new hair growing. Eventually it's just gonna grow out. And then the old hair gets pushed out from the new hair coming in.
Hmm.
So that's the majority of people. Now, if you're gonna stress, which you shouldn't stress at all, because there's nothing to stress about, right?
Yeah, sometimes it's hard. We all stress.
We have to control our stress a little bit and try to be on the happier side if we can. But you can tell a lot with hair loss, whether it's a medical situation, stressful, the hair really shows. You know, a doctor will look at your hair and will understand that there's something wrong with you.
Mm-hmm.
They'll know if you have something medically or you're just losing your hair from the stress. So, yeah, you do lose your hair from the stress. Try not to stress too much. As far as you can have a shock in your life and your hair will completely change the color.
Wow.
Right? Your hair will go from like a beautiful brown to a white because something shocking happened to
you. Maybe your spouse passed away or something.
Something that affected your life can change your hair color in that moment, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's another thing. So again, it's a variety of many different things. We don't know what.
Like obviously, our thoughts and our vibration and our feelings.
Yeah,
and
it's all connected, you know? You know, always treat your hair like the way you treat your skin. So you know if your skin's dry, maybe you're using too much soap. So it's the same thing for your hair. If your hair is dry, maybe you're using too much of something.
Mm-hmm. I know for me though, like I'm in the bad habit of washing my hair every day. Mm-hmm. And if I don't wash it, it looks pretty greasy. So like how long will it take to look like fresh? Mm. How long to get through that greasy phase?
Yeah, so that's the thing. We're gonna find out, I guess.
Yeah, we'll find out.
I think let's experiment. Let's try, let's do 1 week. Where wash your hair, I want you to start with 3 days a week.
Okay.
And then the week after, go down to 2.
Mm-hmm.
And then the week after, maybe stick with 2. If your hair is really greasy, then stick to the 2.
Okay.
If it's really unbearable, then try 3.
Okay.
3, but don't go over 3 because your hair will get used to, you know, it has to take its course.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Okay, I want to ask too. My former best friend, she has a son, and she used to measure him on the wall.
Oh.
And she always noticed that he grew taller, like drastically grew more in the summer months. Mm. So obviously the sun does so much for us, head to toe, and for our growth. So this has led me to believe that our hair must grow faster mm-hmm. in the summer months mm-hmm. or for those people who live in a sunny climate.
Yeah.
So what do you think about that?
So for sure, I mean, hair definitely grows in the hot heat, summer times, because the pores are open, right? Like mm-hmm. when you wash your hair in the hot shower, all your pores are open. So during the summer, it's always open. So it does grow, but it also tends to get greasier as well. Whereas the cold months or in the winter, if you live in winter climates, clearly the pores are closed and you don't get that extra growth or the extra grease. So as far as growing faster, yes, it's possible. Maybe it grows thicker too, but I would say yes.
I think so. You know, I spent a year in Costa Rica, and then after that, like, my hair just grew in better.
Right, well, it could be also like what you were eating, you know, like mm-hmm. maybe you ate different fruits in Costa Rica mm-hmm. that were better for your hair. You know, again, it's like the environment affects your hair.
Mm-hmm.
So like if you're a New Yorker, you're gonna come to the salon all the time.
Yeah.
If you're in Costa Rica, you don't even need a salon because you're in like a natural environment.
Yeah.
Where everything is fresh. The fruit comes from the tree, the water, you just swim in the ocean. So I honestly believe that like where you live does affect your hair, like the way it affects your skin and
Me
your
too.
Mood.
I agree. And I think in an ideal world, we all live in the tropics. I think we're tropical creatures and that's the most natural for us. But we all don't live in the tropics. I mean, I live in Toronto, Eric lives in New York, and millions of people live in cities mm-hmm. and not in the tropics.
Right.
And we just make it work, right?
Yeah.
And it's amazing
still.
Travel to the tropics. But I think for those of us who don't have the luxury of being in the amazing sun very often, we can also supplement vitamin D, and it is not the same, but in my opinion, it helps a little bit. And I think it helps a little bit with the hair growth as well.
Oh, I know the
hair supplements, that's one of the things they put in it. And I mean, yeah, it's not the most natural, the most best, but I think it helps, and it's a great option.
There's a lot of supplements for your hair that people do take. It's funny because I guess people who are vegans don't eat those supplements because they already have those.
Yeah.
You know, they eat the, you know, whatever ingredient is in that supplement, you know, whatever is in that packaging, whatever it is that you're getting for your hair growth. So already it's in there. So you're good. You know, you're good to go. But people who don't, you know, they'll take like a Nutrafol or a, you know, what do you call that? Biotin, you know, or the
biotin.
Pregnancy, the prenatal.
Folate.
Stuff. Yeah, so obviously the supplements do work for your hair, but vegans don't need to worry about these things.
Yeah,
so you know what? That's one of the benefits of being a raw vegan.
That's so true. And I actually trusted someone else to cut my hair in Toronto a couple weeks ago, and this was a freaking disaster. And I called Eric right away and I said, what can I do to get this to grow even faster? Because I wasn't happy with it.
Yeah.
So thankfully he came and fixed it. But he suggested this one supplement, and it was just, it's like everything I eat in my diet anyway. So I'm not concerned. Yeah. It'll grow back fast. But he's right.
It was expensive. It wasn't cheap.
Yeah. So. And I know that one you're talking about, that one's not vegan, but there are some great vegan ones out there as well. And I mean, we'll get into those foods in a bit, but it's like vitamin D, biotin. Some of them have iron, folate, A, C, and E, and we'll talk about the foods in a bit. I just want to ask you a couple more questions.
Of course.
So I'm wondering too, I would think certain types of brushes and combs might damage the hair more than others. So what type of brush do you think is the least damaging to our hair?
Very good question. A lot of people ask me that question. So there's like two types of brush, okay? There's like the brush you use when the hair is dry, and there's a brush that you use when the hair is wet.
Hmm.
Right? Us hairdressers, we're animal rights. We are like, you know, animal activists. We're 100% with PETA.
Yeah.
You know, we care.
Yeah.
We care.
Nowadays,
and that's
I feel
why
like
we're like
everyone cares nowadays.
Yeah,
I feel like not everyone, but a lot of people.
No, especially hairdressers. We're very, you know, people in the beauty industry. We know that there's a lot of pressure on us because there are a lot of byproducts or non-byproducts that people use in makeup and all that stuff. But that has all changed. That's all in the past. Everything now today, it's like everything is like, the more vegan, the better.
And I just want to say too, like, I think it's great to make every effort, if you are vegan, to be as vegan as possible or as raw vegan as possible. But I think in the world we live in, it's really hard to be like 100% right. vegan with the materials of things around us. But you just do the best you can, you know, consciously and with what you know.
It's hard to be 100% in anything, period.
Yeah.
And that's it. You just have to do the best you can and not put that pressure, because that creates the stress. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to lose your hair. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So there's all these, like, you know, it's like a chain of events.
And I just want to say, not put that hate on vegans or other vegans who maybe not call them out for things where you think maybe they're not being fully vegan with something because they're using something. I mean, they're doing the best they can. And I think just the whole world needs to drop the whole hate card with everything too. So.
Oh my God, totally. Because like, no one's ever going to be as good as you, and you're not going to be as good as that other person.
Yeah.
Right? We're all in this world trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
And we all just need to support each other. You know, if you see somebody who's not 100% vegan, it's okay. You don't have to call them out and make them feel bad about themselves.
Yeah.
But maybe you can suggest something and say, hey, you know what? Can I suggest, instead of using that, maybe you can use this?
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's a much kinder approach, and everybody's happy at the end.
Yeah, it's never good to tell people through this. Yeah.
No, we live in a much different world today. You know, I interact with people from all over the world, and they just want to know more about us, like, you know, this Western life that we live. And, you know, I feel like we're all on the right path, and let's just keep going, and, you know, and we're going to look great at the end.
Everyone's
going to have beautiful, healthy hair.
Yeah, exactly. I do want to ask you too, is it true, because my girlfriend who blows out my hair, she said that when you massage your scalp, the hair grows faster. Is that true, or it's good for your hair?
I mean, that would, that's a hard thing. I can't say yes, because you would have to do a whole test. You would really have to massage and see if it really does work and measure.
Yeah, are people really doing these studies? I mean, like, you know,
right,
you
wonder, but it's like a real in-depth study.
Yeah.
But what it does is that it does stimulate the scalp, which is good for hair growth.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it should help. Obviously, if you're gonna stimulate your scalp, you're gonna stimulate the hair growth, right? One thing is interesting is a lot of my clients, after they get a shampoo, they always ask for a cold rinse, which is another thing that stimulates the hair.
Mm-hmm, right? I've heard that, yeah.
And it's amazing because it really brings out the shine. It closes the cuticles, but it also brings out this extra shine in your hair. It's pretty amazing. Yeah, the cold water rinse is always a great way to end your shower. Just the best thing to do is not, if you want to get your whole body wet, go ahead. But what most people do is that they just kind of creep up and they put their hair back and they just touch their hair with the cold shower.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. You know, that's all you need to do. Mm-hmm. Obviously, if you're at a salon, you could ask the shampoo person to finish it in a cold rinse. So that's also a nice little tool to get your hair extra shiny and close the cuticles and all that stuff.
Amazing. Well, that's good to know.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for answering those questions. Mm. I think right now it would be great to get into the foods that are great for our hair as well. Because like I said earlier, the foods I eat and turning raw has totally changed my hair. So it is so key and so important. The nutrition we get and how we eat, it totally shows on the outside through our skin, through the way our hair grows. And I know it's a proven fact, certain things are better than others for your hair and for your hair growth as well. So we can get into that a little bit. I know biotin is a big one that's proven. That's in all the supplements. So that stimulates hair growth as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I know some foods that are high in biotin are avocado, broccoli. There's many raw vegan foods you can find that have different levels of biotin. So this is definitely something you want to include in your diet.
How about coconut? Is that good too?
I would think coconut would be good too, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah, I would think so for sure.
Yeah, right?
Absolutely.
Like
I mean,
olive
oil
and all that stuff?
Yeah, I think just like a like as many plants as you can eat in general too, like the widest variety. It's proven that's just the best thing for your gut, and it's also just the best thing for your hair.
Well, yeah, you know what? Because I love that you know more about what to put into your body, but what I could say is, you could use the same type of fruits for your hair.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, you can take olive oil and just apply it to your hair and use it as a treatment to make your hair stronger and shinier. Or coconut oil will also like hydrate your hair and make it shiny and stronger. When I remember going to my client's house when I used to do like privately, when I lived in California, I used to literally like open their fridge and see what they had. And I'd be like, hey, you want to do a natural treatment? And they'd be like, what? I'd be like, yeah, let me see what you got. I'd take an avocado, I'd cut it in half, put it in the blender with some olive oil, some coconut, I even put an egg in there. and mayonnaise. Well, I even added mayonnaise to it. Is that not vegan?
Not
oh my
vegan,
God. I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. But people could do it without those things, right?
Right, like not the avocado to eat. Not to eat. This
no,
is
yeah,
something
for the
to
external
apply.
Hair.
Yeah.
I know, but still. And then I know a lot of people use lemons to like for the sun to like brighten their hair.
Yeah,
they try
so
to use.
That's another good thing. I used to tell my clients, take lemon and mix it with water and put it in a spray bottle. Mm-hmm. And then if you want to get that blonder look, if you want those hues in your hair to really come out, you can spray it. And in the sun, it'll just get lighter naturally. Mm-hmm. So that's another thing.
That's great.
Yeah.
And then I know vitamin D we already talked about. So that's something that, I mean, I personally do take in supplement form because I don't get enough of it here in Toronto. So that helps as well. And there are many other foods, and there are common vitamins that you see on the supplements. So foods that vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E, the vitamin D, iron is super important as well.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I know many times if people have an iron deficiency, they can have hair loss as well.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah, so there's...
And everybody's different too. That's another thing.
That's another thing. Yeah. Everybody is so different.
They're so different.
That's why I just think like the widest variety of plants you get into your diet and the most natural you eat, even if you're not fully raw, to me being fully raw is most ideal.
For sure.
But even if you're plant-based, just get a big variety. Don't eat the same thing every week. Switch it up. Take the supplements you might need if you're living in a northern climate or you're missing certain things. B12 too, I think that's important. And I know protein is so important for hair growth as well, so I don't think we touched on that yet, but there's many plant-based sources of protein. I eat a super high plant-based diet, like or a super high protein-rich raw vegan diet. I have a video on that. I will link below, but there's so many things that are so high in protein.
You can even apply it to your hair. It's really good.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. But you can soak lentils for, that is just a huge source of protein. Soaked lentils, 8 hours, they're crunchy, they're ready, you're getting mega protein. Spirulina is a major source of protein. Chickpeas, spinach, broccoli. I could go on and on. I do have a video which lists them all, I will link below, but that protein is important for your hair as well. And we touched on the iron.
There's another secret that people in the olden days used to use to treat their hair. Believe it or not, and it is vegan, right? Is beer considered vegan?
Beer? Beer? Not, I don't know if beer is vegan.
Really?
I haven't drank anything in
a long
time.
Well, not drinking.
But
no.
But I don't know. I would think it's not, but that's just my guess. I could be completely wrong.
Well,
maybe you guys comment down below if it is. I don't know.
Yeah, let me know. If you guys think that beer is vegan enough for you, it's actually really good for your hair, believe it or
really?
Not. Really, really good. If you get just open up a can of beer.
I don't know, you guys.
Apply it to your hair. This is one of the oldest remedies for hair, and it works amazing.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, but I'm not promoting beer, you guys. I think if it's toxic
not
the
to drink
of the
it,
body,
not
that
to
is,
drink. Definitely for your hair.
I would think it's
hair.
Toxic, but I mean, I respect others' opinions too.
Yeah, of course.
So I think
I'm not promoting drinking.
No, I think that's an interesting point, but yeah, I just have to make it clear.
Yeah.
But other foods, we talked about iron. There's many plant-based foods that are rich in iron. Some great sources of iron for a raw vegan or plant-based diet are sprouted beans, kale, broccoli, spinach. There's many other things you guys can look into. And another super important nutrient is iodine. So this is so key, and I think a lot of vegans and raw vegans maybe neglect this. I did for the first couple years, and it's so important to make sure you get your iodine. And this is just hugely connected to our thyroid hormones, and it has to do with hair. And if you're deficient in iodine, you can have hair loss as well and just have clumps of hair be falling out. So that nutrient is key as well. And how I get my iodine lately is through my all-in-one supplement, but also through kelp noodles. So I eat those in my salad, and they are a great source of iodine. And there's other plant-based sources as well, but that's my favorite, and it's definitely something to look into. Another really important nutrient you want to get is zinc, and then also selenium as well. So a great source of selenium. I mean, again, that's something I get in my all-in-one supplements, but selenium you can get from your Brazil nuts. In order to get enough selenium, a lot of vegans or raw vegans eat one Brazil nut a day. Selenium is also something that you want to make sure you don't get too much of, because you can have problems with that. Same with having too little of it, and iodine is the same for that. And then zinc, a great source of zinc is something like pumpkin seeds, cashew nuts, things like that. Zinc is very important as well.
I love pumpkin seeds.
Yeah, pumpkin seeds are so good.
They're my favorite.
They're my favorite. They're so good sprinkled on salads, just with a dressing. And they are so anti-parasitic as well, which I always say they're just a great something to include. And they're so inexpensive, which I love as well.
And this is the time of year too.
Yeah. So yeah, make sure you guys are getting all these nutrients. And I mean, vitamin A, it's cantaloupe, carrots, papaya, mango, so many different things. Vitamin C, I'm not going to go over, everybody knows. I mean, orange is everything. Lots of different things have vitamin C. Vitamin E is so important too. So that's very good for hair. It's very important for your hair growth as well as your skin and many other things. So how I love to get vitamin E is I eat chia seed pudding with almond milk. Almonds are a great source of vitamin E. And there's just many other things. I mean, I think we've touched on almost everything. There's a few other nutrients I'm sure we might be missing. But like I said, just get a wide variety of plants into your body, and then you know you're good and you don't have to calculate everything and worry about everything. Take a supplement if you need to. And like I said earlier, going raw has totally changed my hair and I love it. And Eric is a hair
god.
Maybe
I should go raw and I'll grow hair.
Yeah. Eric is in town and he has been eating raw, or yeah, you've been,
eating raw
the last few days with me, and he's loving it. He's saying he feels so good.
Oh my God. I honestly feel great. I have so much more energy, and not that I don't have energy. I do live in New York, so it's already an energy place, but Toronto is kind of like chill for me. And this, all I've been eating is fruits and vegetables, and I feel amazing, and I can't wait to keep eating more of it. So I'm excited.
And last night, my amazing friend, she was over and she created amazing raw vegan gourmet foods for us with delicious sauces and dressings. And Eric was like, I did not know this stuff could taste this good.
Yeah.
And I feel like if everyone knew, they would just transition.
Totally. And it's actually, it's great. It's great for everybody.
Because
it does make you feel good about yourself. Like in a sense, like you feel positive, you feel more enlightened.
Yeah.
There's definitely something connected to it.
Yeah.
It has to be, because that's how I feel.
Absolutely.
Especially the last couple of days.
Yeah.
It's pretty amazing.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. I love it. Well, thank you so much for
being on.
My pleasure. Even though
you're not vegan.
Yeah.
I'm getting there slowly.
But yeah, I think it's good, like non-vegan and vegan.
Don't judge me.
No, I'm just saying it's good you can be friends with non-vegans.
Most
of my friends are non-vegan.
Oh my God.
It's okay, you guys.
I have clients that are the most vegan of vegans.
Yeah.
And I mean, here's one right here.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, I totally respect you guys, and honestly, keep doing what you're doing, because we need more of this.
Thanks.
People are just not aware. They're afraid of it. They don't even know.
Yeah.
So keep doing what you're doing, and
and
really excited.
Yeah,
really
thanks.
Happy.
Well, thank you so much, and thanks for all your knowledge.
My pleasure.
And I know you have a product coming out that I think is vegan, mostly vegan, and so maybe in the future we can share that.
Oh my God, it took me a whole year to make this incredible formula that I literally created in my kitchen about 5 years ago. And you know, I really did think of only what I could use that's plant-based and healthy. And I came up with this amazing styling product. Now, I can't give too much information because it's not launched yet. So maybe we can do another interview when
absolutely.
I have the product, and I'll go more into depth and tell you how to get it. But I'm really excited about it. So honestly, stay tuned for that, because that's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
That's going to change. I think it's going to change the hair industry, because they need something that actually is good for you, that works, and it's good for the environment.
Mm-hmm. And this is natural as possible.
And this is natural. Like, I hate to say it, but most products are not that great.
No, they have all these ingredients on them that you don't even recognize.
You don't even recognize it.
You can't even pronounce the word. It's like this long, and you're like, what am I using on my hair? And your hair is alive.
Oh,
like, it has all the bacteria.
Absolutely. And all the... Most products have alcohol in it, and that's like the worst thing for your hair.
Yeah.
So my product doesn't have any alcohol.
Oh, really?
So the beer...
I'm kidding. I'm just messing with you.
No, but you know what? It's funny that you say that, because the beer, it's not that the alcohol, it's what it does. It just gives you that extra volume.
Wow.
That's what the beer does. It nourishes the hair,
but
it gives you also volume. But who's going to do that? No one's doing that nowadays.
I don't know anyone who's done that.
And I'm not saying you should, but it was an old remedy that, you know, that they did back in the day. Believe it or not, we used to spray champagne or beer in the hair to do a blow dry to give extra volume.
Wow,
so,
interesting.
You know, that's just, again, it's an old remedy and I don't think anybody's gonna do it today.
Yeah.
But there's so much more out there, like Jillian has mentioned, that is mm-hmm. just as effective for your hair, if not better, okay? So yeah. definitely go that route.
And okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep the Miller beer at the bar.
Yeah. Okay. Well, this was awesome. Thank you so much
my
for
pleasure.
Being on. I had
my
so
pleasure.
Much fun with you today. So thanks for sharing everything with my viewers.
You're welcome.
And thank you guys for tuning in. I do hope you guys got some value from this video and learned something. If you did, give it a big thumbs up and I will see you guys next time. Bye.